stars from Lou Grant, Robert Walden, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Bill Day, and George Bulifant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Reilly.
Let's go.
Welcome to the two of you. We're beginning with round two. This is the first game. Here we go. Bing, 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 bing. Push the button already. That we go. All right. Perry, you're ahead, so we're going to ask you to go first. You're going to have A or B.
Okay, I'll take A.
You want A? You're sure? Okay, it is. Paul the pickpocket said, "It's tough being a pickpocket at a nudist colony. The only way I can stay in practice is by picking blanks." You don't play? You don't play, you don't play. Fine. Fine.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Party for it.
Yeah. Is that the Mary Tyler Moore look? It is, indeed, right.
Anne Blythe.
Anne Blythe, yes. Okay, Walden, here we go.
Yes.
Paul the pickpocket said, "Tough being a pickpocket at a nudist colony. The only way I can stay in practice is by picking blanks."
Noses.
What do you say, Bob Baby?
She's so cute.
She is cute.
I said noses.
Well, that's one for her. She got the four. And now we go to you.
I thought there was a bad taste of discussing. I said nose, not two noses. One nose.
What do you say, Mary Tyler Moore?
Mary Tyler Moore says noses.
Okay. Well, Mark, you got to match all six to stay in the game and achieve a tie. It's the first game. You'll get another shot at the other game, of course.
Great.
Ronald McDonald just lost his mind. Today, they caught him out on the road playing with his blank. Ronald McDonald lost his mind. They caught him out on the road today playing with his blank. Okay.
You're gonna be sorry, Wes.
Mark Manon. Here we go. Ronald McDonald just lost his mind. Today they caught him out in the road playing with his blank.
It's not gonna get to me.
Go ahead, say it. Say it.
I don't want to be redundant, but I'll say nose.
What was your first choice?
Well, I want to come back for the second game, so I'm not gonna say
it. Right. Okay, Bob, you're up.
I said burger.
Burger. That means that Perry gets the one to get.
I said burger. It was close to nose.
Burger.
Water. Water pounder.
Burger is his nose?
All right, come on down, Perry. Now Mark, we'll come back in the second game a little bit later. And right now we're going to have to go. It's going to be a super match with this.
Just kept directing it.
Goodbye.
I guess I wanted to get off there, didn't I?
I don't know. It started to go. Are you all right?
Yes.
Started to go while you were still on it. Okay. Now, here we go. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Pinto blank. If you match the answer they gave us most often, you get $500. For matching the second most popular answer, $250, and then for the third, $100. And as you look at the stars, the ones that have a glimmer of intelligence in the eyes, those are the ones who will probably give you the best answers.
Robert.
Intelligent eyes, huh?
I liked what you said, honey.
I said pinto wagon.
Pinto wagon, okay.
We've got one up here. That's it, we've got one.
Pinto bean.
Yeah. Pinto bean.
Pinto bean.
All the folks out there.
Pinto Dean.
Joyce?
Mary.
Mary Tyler Moore, I beg your pardon.
Pinto horse.
Pinto horse. So you have pinto horse, pinto wagon, and pinto bean. Choose one of those, or give us one of those.
Go for all the beans.
They're saying beans out there. You have to make a choice now.
Right now, huh?
Right now.
All right, I'll go for bean.
Okay. Let's see if we've got beans on the $100 number. There's the wagon. That was not bad at all. Okay. Let's see the next one, please. Pinto pony. Well, you got two out of the three they gave you. That's close enough. May we see the big one? You got it. Very good. All right. You've got $500. Means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. However, you are going to spin the wheel and see if you can double your money. Excuse me, it will turn around this way. And step up there and give it a spin, and we'll all root for a double, right? Here we go. Face me, and good luck to you. Here we go. You ready there, Bob? Leave him alone.
I wasn't talking to him. He was talking to me.
Here we go. Blank cooker. Blank cooker. Or blank cooker. Blank cooker.
Okay.
No, you can't say it until I ask for it.
Okay.
And you have to keep facing me, because he's writing an answer. He's finished that now. Now you give us your answer, and if you matches his, you get the money.
Pressure.
Pressure cooker. All right. If he's got pressure cooker on the card, you're richer by $10,000. What do you say?
You should have let me help you.
I'm sorry. I'll take you to dinner to make up for this, okay? I said pressure.
$10,500 for Carol Gibson. How about a little message for America? Here we go. All right, Mark is back here now. We'll begin by asking him to choose A or B.
I'll choose B.
B it is. B says, Ralph said this hamburger must be made out of cat meat. I can tell. When I bite into it, it blinks.
Oh, God.
Good.
We're moving.
Okay, Mark, Ralph said this hamburger must be made out of cat meat, I can tell. When I bite into it, it blinks.
It meows.
Meows is good. Okay, Bob, he said meows.
Well, I said meows. Yeah, I said the same thing. Meows.
Meows. Okay. That's one. We gotta see it. All right.
This is for all the people I love in Fort Worth. Meow.
Meow. All right.
I have no friends but meows anyway.
This hamburger must be made out of cat meat. I can tell when I bite into it, it
meows.
Meow. Four for him. Bill says meow. What do you say, Mary?
Meow.
She says meow. Okay. Harry, you got a little catching up to do here. Here we go. Dumb Donald was so dumb.
Ma, shut up. You're getting on my nerves.
Well, after you sit there and I'll sit here.
Okay.
Dumb Donald was so dumb he spent 2 years. Come here. I said sit here. I said sit here. Sit right here.
Woo. Nice.
Get back in your seat.
I'd like to get back in her seat.
When will you?
Thank you.
He's so dumb he spent 2 years planning a bank robbery. Then all he stole was blank. Dumb Donald was so dumb, he spent 2 years planning a bank robbery, and then all he stole was blank.
Hey, I don't need this show, man. I got the reruns of Newhart.
You're making me so nervous, I can't stand it!
You know what? I don't know. Come and help me.
Here, what?
You know, these people are sicker than the ones we had on last week. Strange about them.
Okay.
Wait a minute, sweetheart. Robert hasn't finished yet. Oh, Bill, get with it, sweetheart.
I'm going to change it. All right,
wait. Here we go. Dumb Donald was so dumb, he spent 2 years planning a bank robbery, and then all he stole was...
the cashier.
The cashier?
No.
It was a pretty blonde lady cashier, was that it? And he took her away. What do you got?
She's so cute, it doesn't matter what she says.
Yes.
I said the inkwell and pen.
Oh, that's cute, yeah.
Sits up there.
It's okay.
What?
They steal those, right.
This may be a match, darling. I can't be too sure. I said all he stole was a teller.
They're cashiers.
Yeah, there's one.
Give it to her.
Okay.
A piggy bank.
Aha! Good.
Such a wit.
Dumb Donald, so dumb, spent 2 years planning bank robbing, and all he stole was...
So you're making a fortune.
The deposit slip.
Very good. Excellent. You got a good one, too?
Ah, I got one hurrah here. The bank teller.
The bank teller.
This
Joyce?
Is remarkable.
Deposit slips.
Deposit slip. Well, I thought that was a definitive answer, but anyway, you got two there.
No, that was my
slip. Now we go to round two, and since he's matched all six, you'll have a choice of A or B.
I'll take A, please.
Okay. Anything you say. Perry, you want A, you've got A. Mother Goose said.
Ooh!
Sorry.
I'm sorry.
You may not know this, but Humpty Dumpty really loves pain. It's strange. He's the only egg in the world that blanks himself. Mother Goose is speaking. Mother Goose is speaking. You may not know this, but Humpty Dumpty really loves pain. It's strange. He's the only egg in the world that blanks himself.
I got it.
You got it?
I got it. I'm
trying
to get it on
the air. You gotta match everybody here, Perry. Stay in the game and achieve a tie. You have a question you want to ask? Is from way over here, way off mic.
I can't say that.
Yes, you can.
No, I don't think so. No. Okay. Here we go. Mother Goose said, "You may not know this, but Humpty Dumpty really loves pain. It's strange. He's the only egg in the world that blanks himself."
Hatch. Oh.
Hatch.
Hatch. Proud. Mean.
Hatch. She said hatch. Now she's got to match everybody.
I don't care what she said. I said fries.
Fries himself, so that means Mark wins again. What do the rest of you have there?
Whips
himself. Scrambles himself.
Blanks himself.
Blanks himself. Okay, Mark.
I blew up there.
Well, this lady is not unhappy as she leaves here. She's got $10,500. Thank you, Perry Gibson. Bye. Here's a little message for you. Watch this.
If you'd like to come to the studio out here in Hollywood to see Match Game in person, write to us. Enclose the self-addressed stamped envelope mailed to tickets, Match Game, CBS Television City, 7800 Beverly Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90036.
Here we go. Well, this young fella, what year are you in? I forgot.
I'm a senior.
You're a senior. He's still in college at the University of Texas, and I suppose if he wins some money here, that would be very helpful to him, right?
Oh, it would definitely be helpful to me.
Yes. Now, what is your major?
Broadcast journalism.
Broadcast journalism?
Is that in Denton?
What's that?
Is that college in Denton?
No, it's in Austin.
You know, Austin,
Hook
Texas.
The horns and all that.
What's the one in Denton?
What's the one in Denton?
Oh,
that's North Texas.
That's in Colorado.
Yeah. Oh.
He's the one who said he went to University of Texas, which is in Austin, and he saw me do The Prisoner of Second Avenue when I was down there.
And you were brilliant.
Yes, I was brilliant in the part, yes.
And then he said he wished he was at the Denton College.
No, he didn't say that. Let's get on with it here, Mark. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, let's have you write down your best answer to this. College of blank. If you give us the answer that they wrote down most frequently, we give you $500. If you match their second most popular answer, $250 for you. Then if you match the third, $100. All right, now look around and see who looks as if he or she might have an answer for you.
Well, I think I'll pick Brett since she has so many friends in Texas.
I say this is going to be fun. I know it's going to work out for us because you're cute and you're from
this is another 1916 answer. Go ahead.
This is for my friend Kelly Rowan, College of Musical Knowledge.
Right. College of Musical Knowledge. Kate Kaiser. Kate Kaiser.
It's 1927, I think.
Right. Okay, who else you want?
Well, I think I'll try Charles.
He doesn't have one.
College of your choice.
Yeah.
And the very pretty Elaine.
Elaine?
The College of Interior Design.
Oh. You know that's not up there, Elaine. You were just stuck and you tried to
Boy.
Fake.
Well,
when
do
you
it
come
again.
Up with a loser, that's really a loser. But we don't want to affect your opinion here of which are the good or bad answers there. But that one really stinks. No, that's College of Interior Design, College of Your Choice, and College of Musical Knowledge are the three they've given you. Now you have a choice of one of those or one of your own.
I think I'll go with College of Your Choice.
Now, wait a minute. What would you have said in the second row? Hard knocks?
Yeah, hard knocks.
Not a bad idea. Hard knocks. That's not a bad answer at all. You think it's going to be up there?
That's a good answer.
Okay, let's take a look at the $100 number. College of Cardinals.
Oh, they had a lot of good baseball here that day.
Yeah.
That's the smell.
What was that, Bill?
Good baseball team.
Good baseball team. No, Bill. All right. He wants the college of your choice. May we see the $250 response? College of Medicine.
Good gravy.
Now it's kind of an oddball answer. I really wasn't expecting that up there. But College of Hard Knocks that I heard in the audience, I thought
like
that
it.
Might be down there somewhere. What else?
School
of Hard Knocks. Oh, all right.
Yeah, we discussed.
Fort Knock. No. Right. I am surrounded by weirdos. Surrounded. All right, last chance here for College of Your Choice. May we see the $500 number?
Yeah.
Wow. You were right all along. Right all along.
I know, Bill.
I am really surprised at that, too. Mark Newland,
it's
we've got many wonderful prizes for you, together with our thanks for being here on Match Game. Thank you. Good luck to you in your college career. Mark Newland, ladies and gentlemen.
Where do those people go? They all fall off a cliff. I feel like
I'd
they're
like
back.
To
they
go. No, I would like
yeah.
to
go. Yeah. Where's
well,
Perry
got
right
to
now?
Go.
Not.
Wait a minute. Hold on.
Wait a minute. Don't let him go.
Hold it. I wanted a ride on that there.
I want to register a complaint.
Right. What's your complaint?
I have a lot, but I'm just going to do one. That is, it is not College of Hard Knocks. It is School of Hard Knocks.
We discussed it.
And we said no, because it is School of Hard Knocks, not College
of Hard Knocks. But the dingbats who were in the audience that day, they said that. Let's settle it all with a little commercial message for you, okay? That's the way to get out. I don't know. Here I am. Listen, we're in luck. We're going to play a quick round of Match Game with somebody in our studio audience. I'm going to start up here and ask Brett a question here to fill in this blank. Don't say now. Say later when I call for it.
Right.
Blank sweeper.
Now, you don't say that now, right?
No, write it down.
Oh, okay.
Because I'm going to ask you to hold it up later.
You got
but
it,
But I
got
to find somebody in the studio audience. What side shall I go
it.
On?
I got it. I know.
No, you sit down.
No, you're not.
You're not
You
me.
Don't play.
I'm the one.
Now, if you don't want to be called on, don't raise your hand. All right? If you want to be called on, raise your hand. What's your name?
Stan Corwin.
Where are you from, Stan?
San Francisco.
You're related to Norman Corwin, the great writer?
Unfortunately not.
You know who he is?
Yes.
Okay. How would you fill in that blank? Blank sweeper.
Carpet.
Brett, have you got... Carpet sweeper! A $50 bill for you. Congratulations. Another one. Charles, you write down an answer to this one, if you would, please. Pittsburgh... blank. Pittsburgh blank. Pittsburgh blank. Can I get through here and talk to some of these people here? Thank you. Am I stepping on your purse there? Hello there. How do you do? Oh, yeah. My, you're heavy. What's your name?
Amber.
Where are you from?
Pittsfield, New Hampshire.
Welcome.
Long way from home.
How would you fill in that blank, Pittsburgh blank?
Pennsylvania.
Yay! Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Charles?
Oh. No, he doesn't have Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
I'm sorry.
This poor lady I crushed. How would you fill it in?
I'd say Pittsburgh, Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh, Pittsburgh? Pittsburgh, Pittsburgh? No, we say Pittsburgh blank. You have to put something in. She said Pennsylvania. Going out of my mind here. Yes, sir. What's your name?
Terry Heaney.
Where are you from?
Chicago.
Pittsburgh what?
Pirates.
Pirates. Pittsburgh Pirates.
Yeah! Yeah!
$50 for you. Congratulations. Thank you. That's all the time we have tonight. Join us next time for Match Game. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are beautiful bath faucets in polished satin chrome with natural onyx inserts and dependable valvette system. Polar faucets, the tradition with quality and craftsmanship. And Zero shirts, the ultimate in classic design featuring the celebrated purest button-down, luxurious fabrics, distinctive pattern Zero. Nothing is obvious except the quality. And a grill and Eskimo pie. Dairy fresh vanilla ice cream covered with special chocolate flavor coating. Eskimo pie, refreshing and delicious anytime for an all-fresh treat. And Blue Luster Shampoo and Blue Luster Plus Carpet Shampoo with grease cutters and brightness to remove ground-in dirt and grime. And an 11-piece manicure set and the only solution, new family health concept, one conditioner for both hair and skin, is the only solution worth trying. And from Hawaiian Tropic comes an attractive beach mat and Hawaiian Tropic natural tanning lotions and oils. Hawaiian Tropic, the tan of the islands. And a frying pan and Hollywood Safflower Oil, higher in polyunsaturates and other oils. Hollywood Safflower Oil contains no cholesterol. From Hollywood Foods. Speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program has been edited for broadcast.